It has been said that Sir Rowan Hamilton would have come up with Schrödinger's equation 90 years before Schrödinger himself did, if only he believed that particles could be waves. This is because Hamilton studied the relation between optics and mechanics, and the relation between ray optics and wave optics. It was known that light rays propagate according to Snell's law, and particles according to Newton's law. Hamilton's study of the analogy between light rays and particles resulted in Hamiltonian mechanics, which is still widely used today. It was also known that light is actually a wave. We know that the wavefronts are perpendicular to the direction of the light rays. So if we have an equation that describes how light rays propagate, we can infer a formula that describes how the wavefronts propagate. This is the iconal equation. Similarly, from Newton's law, we can infer an equation for how a particle's wavefronts would propagate. This is the Hamilton-Jacobi equation, and it describes the wavefronts of Schrödinger's wave function. In his Nobel lecture, Schrödinger extensively describes the relation between ray optics and wave optics, and its analogy with particle mechanics and wave mechanics. In the paper where Schrödinger explains his equation, he remarks that the conceptual foundations for his equation were better known to Hamilton than to many physicists of Schrödinger's day. Therefore, it can be said that Schrödinger finished what Hamilton had started already 90 years before.